Hello everybody to the Kenny Hack today. This is kind of the experiment I'm working on today. This is just a piece of basswood that's been pre-coated with the 50% Kenny Hack. Even coat put on, the excess wiped off, blow dried till it was dry. On the right side, I'll be putting some coats of the watercolor that you've seen me use in previous videos. To kind of put over the top of the Kenny Hack to kind of lighten up the stain again, to kind of bring it back closer to the natural wood color. Just try to decrease the amount of stain effect. On the left side is a mixture of just regular Rust-Oleum paint and acetone, just kind of making a whitewash, diluting down the paint enough to where it mixes into the acetone and you can paint it on really thin. This is kind of a first try at this. It's kind of sloppy, but we're just going to see how they compare side by side. I never really wanted to mess with paint before. I didn't have a very good ventilation system hooked up yet. And burning paint fumes is very nasty smelling. So that's kind of why I started off with the white watercolors. It doesn't put out near as much fumes as burning paint or having to mess with acetone to thin it. It'd kind of be a preference, so you know, we'll see how the results turn out, if one turns out better than the other as far as helping produce a blacker image with the burn. I'm gonna just burn the same image across all three at the same settings so we can do a side-by-side comparison and we'll kind of go from there. But this is the setup: white watercolor wash, paint thinned out wash, just the bare 50-50 mix, and we'll see how it does. So you can see here, this is the image I'm going to be burning. It's going to be about 4 inches tall, a little over inch and a quarter wide, inch and a third wide. Just doing a little strip of this image as a test. These are my typical settings with the 50-50 mix and the white watercolor. That's 250 inches per minute, which is about 6,350 millimeters per minute, if you're in metric, and at 22% power. With a 250 dpi resolution. The native resolution was set at 500 dpi. Like I said in previous videos, I find running, if you set the native to 500 and then run light burn at 250, it seems to help darken up the image. It's basically putting double the newsprint dither per pass, and it just seems to help it burn darker. But that's the one I'll be running on all the test patterns. Like I said, I'm going to run all the settings for this. It's probably going to be too dark a setting for just the bare 50-50. Normally, I'd probably cut that back to like 18% for just the bare 50-50, no watercolor over it. But like I said, we're going to run them all the same and see how they all come out. And you'll see in this video, I'm out of my garage. Finally got my fume hood built. It's a 6 foot wide, 3 foot tall, 30 inches deep. It's got three different bays on it. Right now the one bay's just got a photo booth set up in it. Got a 3D printer on order that's probably gonna be set up in this mid bay when it shows up. I have a 20 inch box fan that blows out the window, keeps a lot of air moving through this hood, so I no longer have to worry about any fumes. It does have a drop down plexiglass cover that's a dark red, blocks all the blue green spectrum. It doesn't make it very good if you can't see any color through it, and it's really dark, but it does block all of the blue green spectrum, so works pretty well. They messed up my order and I got two more sheets of that coming right now. I got clear glass in the other bays, but I'll be replacing them with the red as soon as they get here. You can see it's already burning through on the first pass here. I didn't really tweak on this image to make it come out looking the best, just basically drug it right from the photos. right into light burn. Normally you have to tweak on the photos a little bit to kind of enhance them. But like I said, this is just a test board, and just kind of want to see what the results, if there's an improvement between the watercolor I have been using and using thinned out paint. Like I said, I was just never wanted to use paint before, just because of all the fumes and the what my setup I had in my garage. I just couldn't get enough ventilation to handle the fumes of burning paint. So now that I'm set up better for it, maybe I'll start trying a few more experiments with that kind of work. See how I like it. I'd rather not even have to mess with the paint and the acetone and the chemicals. I do enough of that at work. I'd rather not have to do it in my personal life too. So I really like using the white watercolor just because it is a lot less toxic to handle. Working with acetone is a bad, strong chemical. You don't want to have that constantly on your skin. It does go right through your skin and builds up, and it's hard on your liver and kidneys. Look up the effects of acetone exposure sometime, and it's something you really don't want to be handling all the time, especially without kind of rubber glove protection. So we're just about done with the first one. It's only going to take about 6 minutes per little 4-inch image. That's the benefit of the Kenny hack, is doing a 4-inch by 4-inch image takes like 20-30 minutes. They go really fast on wood. You're not sitting here taking 2 hours to burn a little 4-inch by 4-inch image. You can do them really fast. So that's what's really the great thing about the Kenny hack, is you can run as fast as you want to push your laser to. I run a lot faster than most people feel comfortable. Most people say, well, the manufacturer says don't go over 3,000. They're programmed to where they can go up to 9,000. You've seen in the other video, it burns up a really nice, you can get a nice material test pattern even at 9,000. You can see this is running at 6,000 and how smooth it's running. It's not, I don't have the frame bolted down or anything right now. I'm gonna make little holder feet for it to keep it in position, just so I can burn a template on the baseboard, and so it stays square to that template. But as long as you're doing stuff over 4-inch size and it's moving the full length passes, it's not making any sudden quick changes for small areas, running at 6,000 doesn't seem to affect this machine at all. It seems to run really smooth. But if you're not comfortable at that speed, you know, find the speed and power settings that work for you. So this is the first one. I'll check back with you when I get done with the rest of them, and we'll do a side by side and see how they all turned out. So here are the results, and kind of before we go over them, you'll see there's a little bottom section here. Kind of remembered I had this poster paint, which is a non-toxic washable paint. It, you know, you can basically dilute it right into water. It's kind of like a latex paint. It's probably made safe for kids. Had this laying around for another project I did a while back, and thought, well, you know, while we're trying a ink-based watercolor, acrylic paint diluted with acetone, said, well, let's try to find some latex-based diluted with water and see how that does. And so the watercolor, it was probably on the lightest section of wood, and it probably did come out the lightest of all of them. But the good thing I found about the watercolor is it seems to be the one that comes up with the least amount of grit on it. You know, it, that's from previous tests. It comes up pretty clean. You don't get a lot of smudge. All the other ones burn darker, but you can always kind of smudge some of the black off if you kind of rub on it. So you got to be careful. But you can see the watercolor probably come out the lightest, but still 5% more power. It'd have been fine. The 50-50 with no watercolor treatment over it, or whitewash, was definitely the darkest. But then you're going to have the darkness of the stain to deal with as well. Like all the other ones kind of come back to a little more of a white color. You see the acetone in the acrylic paint, it did really well. It turned nice and black. And I was kind of messy with this, but the problem I see with using that is that acetone is so thin, it's tough to, you know, keep it clean and not be dripping everywhere. You can see any place I had little drips, it pooled up, and even though I wiped it off, them drip marks still stuck on there. So it was a lot messier to deal with. The watercolor in here on the bottom is that latex-based paint. Just dilute it right in water. They both paint on really easy. Go on, you can put a nice heavy coat on, wipe it off, and it comes out with a really smooth coat. So yes, the acrylic paint and acetone is an option if you have them. Everybody's probably got that stuff laying around, and it is another option. But like I said, you're dealing with acetone, which is a chemical you really don't want to have to be messing with day in and day out if you're not protecting, you know, keeping it off of yourself. It does have long-term health effects. So I think in the future, I'm glad I happened to try that little bottle of latex paint. I think it's probably the hands-down winner. It come out almost just as dark as a straight 50-50. I mean, to be honest, this center strip of this wood was the darkest grain in here. So it's going to come out naturally darker than the outside edges were kind of naturally lighter. So that might attribute a little bit to why it's a little bit darker than the other two outside strips. But when you compare it directly above to the straight 50-50, the 50-50 is still slightly darker, but that one helped bring out more of a gray tone in the wood. It's kind of tough to see on camera. It's a little easier to see in person, but like I said, they're all options to use. Once you apply it over the top of the Kenny Hack as your base coat, they'll all work really well. You can still maintain super high speeds as fast as you feel comfortable running, and still very low power settings. Generally, putting a white wash over it, you run about 5% higher than what just the bare 50-50 is. So if you're at 20% to get that, go to 25% on your white washes and you'll get about the same darkness. Mine's a 20 watt Ortur. Just play around with it. You'll figure out your own numbers. But thanks for joining me. Another little experiment. Definitely learned something today that this little bottle of tube of kids' poster board paint, it's, like I said, non-toxic. You're not dealing with any harsh chemicals. I can't smell anything coming out of my hood, but I imagine the fumes are quite a bit less than working with acrylic paint. And the fumes, that acrylic paint is terrible smelling. I just didn't even want to mess with that stuff until I had a fume hood. But once again, thanks for joining. Like, subscribe, share. Can't wait to see some other people's results on the forums, and thanks for watching.